Yo, what's going on, guys? This is going to be your guide for Prime Wars in Once Human. This isn't going to be necessarily how you do Manibus or how you do the Servitor or the Hound, but just a general guide on how to go about completing Prime Wars. I've personally hosted a ton of Prime Wars, and this is how I've had success in them. But first, before we get into the actual strategy, there's some etiquette that I like to talk about. So when you're doing Prime Wars, you see you have all these builds to defend the Resonator. A lot of people, they like to leave them behind. Don't do that. Don't do that. When people want to host Prime Wars, don't leave your builds, because as you can see, if I want to demolish, it says I cannot do that. And if this is not the strategy I want to implement, I don't really have a choice. You gotta sort of deal with other people's builds. Not to mention, you get all your mats back. You get all your mats back. So make sure once you're done hosting a Prime War, you're done with your builds, get rid of them. Not to mention, also, if we look at this, some of these are basically destroyed, and they're not going to do anything but get destroyed once you do a Prime War. So get rid of them. Also, another thing people like to do beyond just leaving their mats is they like to build out of wood. Don't build out of wood. Don't build out of wood. It's just a waste of time. It's a waste of space. And you have a limited number of resources that you can use to defend the Resonator. Good thing that there is none here, but I've had a tendency to show up to host the Prime War and see tons and tons of fences made out of wood. They just get destroyed the moment the Prime War boss touches them. Do not use wood. Period. End of discussion. You will get your mats back. I've tried to tell people, build out of marble. Like, if this gets destroyed, you'll get your mats back. So it's not like you're losing steel or brick or anything. So yeah, just do that. Now, on to the actual setup of it. So basically, you're gonna have the Resonator here, and beyond the mana bus, you'll have silver pools where the bosses will spawn, somewhere out in the field. I believe there is one down over here, if I can show you guys. But basically, that's where, besides the mana bus, that's where the Prime War bosses will spawn. I can't seem to find it right now. But basically, what you want to do is, for your main defense, you want to build basically like castle around it. So you start with like a 3x3 with the core centered out, and then you go, you leave a space, and then you build out another one, you build out another like circular thing around it, and then a third layer, you'll build again like another circular layer around it. So it'll be like three layers deep, and then you'll have walls pretty decently high up. I tend to like to go three or four walls up, depending on if it's a servitor or not. A servitor, you're gonna want to build just a giant ass cage, but that's around the silver pool. But for this, three or four walls up will do. And if you do the math out, 2 times 3, that's 6 walls deep. So decent amount of defenses. Now the secondary defense will be a little further away. I usually like to do it at the halfway point. So say like that oil rig is where the silver pool is. I'd probably put a intermediary wall basically straight through all the way around. This way, if they get through what will be our primary defense, they have one more wall to get through to get to our base. Yeah, you just make a giant wall. I like to call it the wall of toxic. Oh, here it is. So yeah, basically right where those fences are, in other words, is where I make a giant wall. I just go from this ledge all the way over, would be the secondary form of defense. And then the primary form of defense, as you can see, sort of already built here, except I would raise these platforms. So if I was to show you guys, so you can actually raise them way, way, way up. So I would basically go from here, and I just build an encampment around this silver pool. This way, When they spawn, it gives you enough time to missile them. They basically stay put. The only difference is when it comes to servitors, they're the flying ones. They like to, they don't like to stay put for very long. But what you do in that case is pretty much as far distance as this is, you basically make a circle. And then on the outer wall, so basically right here, if I was to show you, so get just a normal wall, put walls around this ledge and just build a tower, build a cage basically for servitors. But basically that's what you want to do. There's three forms of defenses: one directly around the spawn, a midway point, and then around the actual resonator itself, all the way up there. As it goes for winning the Prime War, there's a few things that you guys need to do, and takes a lot of materials beyond just setting it up. So the strategy is to make a ton of cannons with a ton of missiles. For the normal Prime War bosses, you're gonna need biomass missiles, but for Manabus specifically, you need red plasmas. That's a yikes and half. So basically, if you don't have that specialization, try to find someone that does, so you're able to complete it. But pretty much, you're not gonna make any cannons on the actual defenses themselves. Basically, what you'd want to do is a little bit away. So if I was putting up a cannon, I'd probably put one somewhere around here, and I would just sort of spread them out. If it's a singular Prime War boss, I'd sort of put it on either side of it. I wouldn't put it in a direct line from the spawn down over there to the resonator. So basically, like right here or over here would be great, because there's no actual direct line to the resonator, so it's not going to get destroyed. If you put it either on any of the defenses that for the resonator or the actual like silver goop, it will get destroyed. A lot of people have been having this problem. Don't have this problem. Put your turrets and your machine guns all the way, well, not all the way away, but a decent distance away, so they don't get destroyed, and you can just keep pumping out damage on the shield. Now, again, you're going to need, I wouldn't say a terrible amount, but I'd say anywhere from 6 to 10 per Prime War, and I would say at least 100 missiles per, just to be safe. Obviously, you won't need them, but people tend to miss. People tend to mess up a little bit, so just to be safe. Now, as it goes for the actual DPS phase, once the shield goes down to the missiles, you're going to want to hop off the cannons, and for the people who are not on cannons, you're just going to want a straight DPS. There are technically two phases for each. And each prime boss is different. For the dog, once you get them down to around 15% HP, the dog will disappear, basically fly up in the sky. You can't do nothing about it, but it'll crash down on the resonator. There is a, I want to say, 5-second window to straight DPS. So once you get the dog down, he disappears, you just run back to the resonator, wait for the dog to crash, and just straight DPS until it's dead. For the Ravenous Hunter, what it'll do is it'll shoot up a few times and basically create a giant nuke. When that happens, you just look up into the sky and you just try to DPS the nuke down as best you can. Then you go back to the Ravenous Hunter. Now, as it goes for the Servitor is a little bit more of a tricky one to do, because it'll basically play like, I guess it's called Three Card Monty or something like that, or like you put the P in the cup. Basically one of those street games that are meant to hustle you. But basically what happens is the servitor, the flying boss, will split up into three different servitors, and it'll do like a little sequence where one of them is different than the other two. You don't want to shoot at all until it stops, but basically the black and silver one is the not imposter. The blue, gray, and black one are the imposter. So basically it'll go dun 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 dumb. And then if you when it stops on them, that's the one that you want to shoot. And it's different every time, so I can't tell you, oh, just shoot the left one or shoot the middle one or shoot the right one. Every time is different. You just have to wait. And if you end up shooting the wrong one, well, I can tell you a lot of people are going to get very, very upset with you. Because then it basically causes direct damage to the resonator. And theoretically, you can insta-lose a Prime War just because of that. But that's basically how you go about doing the server. Now, as it goes for the Mana Bus, again, is very, very different than all of them. The Mana Bus basically likes to spawn on top of the Resonator, and you, unlike the other Prime Wars, you need the Red Plasmas. Basically, what you want to do is you're going to shoot the Red Plasmas at the Mana Bus's hands, and then the shield will come down. And your goal is to pop all the flowers off of the Mana Bus's arms. Once you do that, one of the arms will go up into the sky. It is a pain in the ass because, well, if you're not constantly DPSing the arms, it's constantly doing damage to the Resonator, all bad things. But that's basically how you go about it. And yeah, that's basically how you win Prime Wars, is that's the defense, that's the strategy, and yeah, that's how you break it down. And if I can reiterate a point, get rid of all your builds. Let other people make their builds in Prime Wars. It's very agitating. And yeah, well, hopefully this guide helps you guys out. And as always, take care, and I'll talk to you guys later.